Hi guys, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. In this lesson, we're basically going to look at how you can explore the subject of modes, a very commonly studied topic by a variety of musicians, using just triads, which you may already know or should already know. So if you're watching this lesson, I hope you know your triads, major and minor, or at least a few of them, if not all the 12. And I'm going to do a lot of videos on modes. This lesson is just to show you how to get a modal sound, just to experience the flavor of a mode. Okay, so generally we look at modes from a major scale. You have all your 7 modes, you know, it starts off with the usual, right? Ionian, Dorian, Phrygian, Lydian, Mixolydian, Aeolian and Locrian, which are all derived or are degrees or built as degrees from the major scale. But the way I like to look at modes very often in my compositions is to look at them as their own scales. Just forget the fact that it came from major. We take all the time in the world to learn our majors, do our exercises and drills. Let's do the similar thing if we like those modes. So I really love the Dorian. I quite enjoy Phrygian, which we are going to do today. Lydian is awesome. A lot of guitar players use that, like Joe Satt and the like. So ideally, you should try and look at these scales, these modes rather, and just as scales or, you know, ragas or whatever you want to call them. It's just a set of 7 notes. So that's what we are going to try and do in a very simple way, hopefully, in this lesson. So if you haven't already, don't forget to like the video, share the lesson, turn on that bell icon for notifications, and subscribe if you haven't already. Right, so in this lesson, we are just going to look at 4 of these scales or 4 of these modes due to the volume of data this whole lesson covers. So let's get cracking with the first one, which I really like, which is the Dorian mode or the Dorian scale. So we have C major, which is all the white notes of the piano keyboard starting on C. To build a Dorian, it's quite easy. You flatten the third, flatten the seventh, which is B becoming B flat. Right, this is just a nice way to get the sound of the mode. You know, just hold a C, a drone here. Okay, so to get a nice modal sound, we are going to use some triads which are built from the Dorian and pretty much from all the scales which I'm going to share with you in the video. Okay, but just remember that to form the Dorian, flat 3, flat 7. Okay, another way I guess you can look at the Dorian is if you know the natural minor or the Aeolian, which is, if you're aware of C minor, you take the 6 and you raise it, as we call it. Okay, just remember the fact that it's a major sixth or just a normal sixth. Right, so now let's look at how you can build triads from the Dorian. And this entire lesson is supplemented with all my handwritten notes. I've notated everything in neat circles and shapes and whatnot. So do head over and get yourself a copy while you're learning it or whenever. Okay, so to build a triad from any scale, the first suggestion is always have the scale written down in a neat round circle, not in a line, C, D, E flat, not like that. Write it in a circle because it really helps you get your triads. Triads is nothing but take any note from that circle, which is the scale, skip one. So I'm skipping the D and playing an E flat. Not E because Dorian has E flat. Then I skip the next one, which is F, and then play the next one, which is G. So that's the first triad, also known as C minor, as you may know. Right, so after we've got ourselves C minor, what do? You just go to D, form that triad, you'll get D minor, then move forward, you'll get the E flat triad or E flat major chord. Then you go to F, you'll get the F major triad. Okay, then you go to G, you'll get the G minor triad. Then you go to A, which is the major sixth, and you're going to get the diminished triad, which is not so friendly a sound, so just know that it exists. Then you do the 7 flat, which is your B flat major. Right? Okay, so to get a really nice Dorian sound, you can start by just exploring these triads. And as you explore, figure out what makes this Dorian sound unique. If you ask me, it's the combination of a minor third with a major sixth. So if you actually create a chord progression which is involving that, maybe C minor and F major, right? You can play either F major with the same drone C bass, or you can even move it. But that creates a very obvious change of movement in your song. So these are very good Dorian mode chords, because what did I say earlier? What are the unique notes of the mode? The unique notes are definitely the A. A differentiates it from, well, minor. And then you have the E flat, which differentiates it from the C major. C major used to have this, C minor has that. So Dorian has that, which is very unique. So if you find chords, or even if you build your melody to highlight these unique notes, your job is going to be really, really straightforward. You'll always be landing at a very modal sound, as we call it. Okay, so C minor will work because it's the home chord. So always start with your tonic chord. Tonic chord is C minor. Then move up by one. The 2 minor is really nice. It's a very good Dorian sound because it has that A in it. E flat major is also nice, but it's more like a tonic sound because it's more like a C minor 7th. Okay, but this one's very, very Dorian. So if you take C minor, right, you can do that progression pretty much all the time. Right? You can even do like an occasional B flat. You know, that creates a very brave sound, I guess. And G minor, C minor. These are all chords or triads from the C Dorian scale. F major over with C, D minor, back to. And if you're doing it melodically, follow the same rule. Stress on that 6, major 6th. That's the minor 3rd. You could even hold down just those 2 chords. C minor with F major, or C minor with D minor, and you get a very, very nice Dorian sound. So this is about how you get a Dorian sound. What did we use? Triads, right? Form the scale C, D, E, E flat, F, G, A, B flat, C. Then you derive all the available triads, and then you have a lot of explorations. You can start with just a drone C, build a very ambient bass with all the modal chords there. And then you can even float around the left hand to play the roots of those new chords from the mode. Very funky, right? Okay, so that's about the Dorian. And as I mentioned earlier, I want to discuss a few more modes. Not all, ideally. We'll leave that for lessons to come. The next one I would really like to share with you is the Mixolydian mode. I have done a lot of lessons on this mode in other contexts, like using it with the circle of fifths and building more rock progressions, right? So let's just look at the Mixolydian again. It's basically a 7 flat. From the C major scale, what's your 7 flat? B flat. Again, the process remains the same. Write it down in a neat round circle. So what makes this Mixolydian mode very unique? It's definitely the flat 7, as I mentioned, but also the major 3rd, maybe even the perfect 4th. A nice Mixolydian sound right there. Also differentiates it from the Lydian with that. We'll come to Lydian shortly. So as always, the format for creating like a very modal sound using triads, you start with the home chord or the tonic chord, which in the Mixolydian is going to be C major. Write down all your available triads. Let's build it together. You have C major, then you have D minor, E diminished because of that B flat, F major, G minor, A minor, B flat major, C major. Let's do that again. C major, D minor, E diminished, F A C, F major, G minor, then A minor, B flat major, C major. Okay. So what's the unique chord? B flat. What are the chords which have that particular note, B flat? B flat major itself, which you have there. And then you have even maybe a G minor, a more milder Mixolydian sound because it's a minor chord. B flat major, a very strong sound. So a common Mixolydian progression could be the 7 flat major, as we call it. Then the 4 major, which is also very important, and then back to tonic. So you have. Just see in the bass. Or you could just do C major with a chord which highlights the unique note, which is B flat, maybe a G minor, come back to the major so that you bring back that major 3rd tonality, so it's a bit more brave or a bit more epic sounding than maybe the Dorian is like overcoming something which is more sad. Being brave about it, right? That's Dorian. While Mixolydian, like, used in a lot of rock songs, and it gives you that very grand and epic sound, which the major scale actually does not give you. It's these scales which give you the very thematic or movie-like sound. So rather than learning this maybe specifically with a jazz context in mind, it's good to learn it with hopefully a few other approaches, because people use this in movie themes, they use it in rock songs, in even pop songs if you think about it. So anyway, that's about the Mixolydian. The process remains the same. Write the scale in a neat round circle, find all the available triads, label them, template them, so you can do it for other scales as well, or rather other keys as well, not only C, and then find out the unique notes, and then create a chord progression using the normal stable chord, which is 1-3-5 of the scale, and then the unique note, the chord built out of the unique note. So now let's do a couple of other scales, which I actually call as exotic scales or exotic modes, because they have intervals which are a bit rarely used, namely the flat 2, sharp 4. Now, how are we going to figure this out? Let's do it together. Let's move forward. All Right. So now the next mode for our discussion, Lydian. What is Lydian? Basically, a major scale with a sharpened four. As opposed to, it'll be, you have the sharp four. Right. Again, I'm looking at Lydian more as a scale, not as like the mode of a major scale, which we will definitely get to in another lesson for sure, because that's another application of modes, I guess, right? So now let's move forward with the Lydian, which is C, D, E, F sharp, G, A, B, C, C, B, A, G, F sharp, E, D, C. Again, you're realizing the obvious, right? What makes this mode unique? The sharp 4, because I just told you it's sharp 4 of the major scale. We're used to that normal 4, but So the Lydian is a very dreamy kind of scale, right? It has a very dreamy or ambient vibe. So with respect to the C Lydian, 2 major, 3 minor, 4 sharp diminished. Not a very common sound, so maybe you can ignore that, but just remember you have a 4 sharp diminished. In this case, F sharp diminished. Then 5 major, 6 minor, then you have 7 minor, and then okay. So again, if you're building unique Lydian chords, what will they be? Well, I think you're already guessing it. This one, right? Anything with that F sharp. And I really think anything around C, D major will be like a very traditional Lydian sound. You can even add like a E minor. Over C, it'll become like a C major 7th. So, okay. And if you're improvising a melody, try to start by improvising over the chord tones. Da-da-da, da-da-da, da-da-re. Right? Just play your notes of the chord. And do-do-do. You can actually compose music with those notes. A very Lydian option. So if you want to just do a two chord progression, just do C major, D major. Very Lydian right there, right? The last one for this lesson, which I thought of sharing with you, well, there are so many scales, right? So if you think about this, you have a lot of work to first of all write down the scale, figure out what are the available triads, then figure out what is the unique note, and then try to build chord progressions around what's normal or tonic or home sounding, and then what's the colorful option, you know, available. But that process, if you keep doing scale after scale, you start getting more acquainted, or the scale starts coming to you more naturally as opposed to very theoretically. A lot of my students over the years, whenever we start doing modes and these fancier subjects of music, which are like at the last few chapters of a big music theory textbook, right? The challenge is we always brand it as an advanced chapter, but you could tackle the problem, you know, while you're learning minor scales or while you're learning anything. If you're learning chord progressions, learn some chord progressions on Dorian, learn some on Mixolydian. You have Beatles songs like With a Little Help from My Friends, which is Mixolydian. You have Michael Jackson's Earth Song, which is on Dorian. You have Mad World. You have The Doors. Almost every song they've ever written is not on major or minor. It's on Dorian, right? You have Lydian, which is played, and it's one of the most favorite scales, you could say, by guitar players like Joe Satt, who really loves shredding on that particular mode or scale, right? So it's also important to listen to music. So moving on to the last mode for our discussion on modes, the Phrygian. Okay, so this is how you build Phrygian. okay? Really love this sound. Okay, that's the sound. So how do we build it? Flat 2. So the beauty of this scale is it makes a flat 2, which is like a horror movie interval, sound really beautiful. It really sounds so pleasing to the ear when you flood it with all the other stuff. Sounds also very calming for some reason. Okay, coming to the chords. Before that, let's finish the scale. Flat 2, flat 3, normal 4, normal 5 or perfect 5, flat 6, flat 7, root. I guess it's a very commonly used Spanish scale. You find this used a lot in a lot of Spanish flamenco music, right? So you'll find this. Okay, so what are those chords we played right now? So we've done, let's build the triad. So you have C minor. Again, I hope you've plotted it out in a neat round circle. You can always pause this video and write it and then follow along. The video is not going anywhere, neither am I. So follow along. So you have C minor, which is the 1 minor. Then you have the 2 flat major. Why do I brand it as 2 flat? Because D flat is the 2 flat from the root. D flat. Then you have the 3 flat major. Okay. So far we've gone C minor, D flat major, E flat major. Okay. Then you have F minor. Okay. Then you have... you have a G diminished, which is a little weird, but just know it's there. 5 diminished. Then you have 6 flat major, 7 flat minor. I love that chord. Just now play around. Now what's unique? The same question. What is unique? The 2 flat of Phrygian is obviously unique. And one might argue that it differentiates it from the Aeolian or the minor scale. In music, as I've said in this lesson quite a few times, I think, the major and the minor scale are the most popular, used in like 90%+ of music. At least most of the music you find on the popular radio stations and the hit search results on YouTube. So whenever you flood the music with a flat 2 or a sharp 4 or the Dorian vibe or any of these unique notes, it just hits the listener, right? And I'm sure if you present it with passion, people are really going to get your vibe. Okay, so C Phrygian again. This is what I would use very commonly with C Phrygian, because you have the C minor, home base. D flat major brings out that D flat. Can even do a timid B flat minor. And just play around with the chords. And I'm playing all these chords with a C bass. Sometimes I sneak in that natural E, but I mean, you can do that, it's fun. Okay, so all of these triad movements can really serve a very good melody on that particular mode, and it also inspires the melody. Like if you play Phrygian chords, even you might just flow easily on the Phrygian scale by composing a melody. Like for example, la da re ru 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 ru. I can't go out of that scale because I'm playing the modal chord. So it really helps you identify the mode, right? So that's about Phrygian. So what have we done so far in this lesson? Actually, we're pretty much done with the lesson. We've explored four modes. We've explored Dorian, Mixolydian, Lydian and Phrygian, right? Four modes, or rather four scales. We formed them, then we've written them in a neat circle, then we've built all the triads, then we've located the unique note of each scale, and then we've vibed with that unique note around the home tonic chord, which for Dorian was a C minor, and then a unique chord around that would be F major. Okay, with respect to Mixolydian, you have like your 7 flat major, which is B flat major here, with the next one, Lydian. You can do a 2 major, which is giving you that sharp 4, F sharp. And then for Phrygian, you take C minor, which is the home base. Then you take the 2 flat major. Sounds really interesting, really mysterious. And then back to the minor, which is home. You really left home. E flat is also nice. D flat. Back to home. Right? So all of these modes could be played ideally with a bass, constant bass in the left hand, not doing too much movement here. That's the point of modes. You want to absorb the sound. So if the root lasts for a bit longer, especially for someone who's new to the subject of modes who has not heard too much of it, it's always good to linger on, or to play the drone, as we call it, in the left hand on the piano. Hear that with respect to whatever you're doing in the right hand. And in this lesson, we've looked at triads in the right hand. There are lots of other ways people would use their modes in different genres with different contexts in mind. We will get to that, but for now, this lesson is hopefully done to convey what are the important notes of the mode, how you build the triads or the chords from these modes, how you improvise, how you get your chords working together in a progression. And yes, that's pretty much it. So you need to practice this well, but I would always recommend write them down. Use a book, pen, paper, pencil, whatever you want. Write it down neatly, stare at it, and then try playing it. And that's how you work forward. Don't play until you know what you're playing, especially for a topic which might be very new to you. So when you're starting like that, try to write it neatly, and then automatically your brain will start flowing. Okay, guys, again, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. What I'm going to do at the end of this lesson, I'm just going to improvise sort of aimlessly, so you can get a feel of all the modes. And before I get to the improv thing, it'll be great if you can like, share the video, leave us a comment, subscribe, turn on that bell for notifications. And we also have all these notes which are available for all my lessons available on our Patreon page. So do head over there for a small monthly subscription. You get regular PDFs, backing tracks, and a lot more, right? So now let's just jam and end the lesson. Thanks again for watching the lesson.